Come on now, Professor. We know you're in there. Our boss needs that book of yours, and he needs it now. Hey, Boast, I think they dozed off in there. How about you be a nice gentleman and give him the old wakey-wakey, yeah?
My pleasure. They're gone! Ain't gonna like this one bit.
Gone! I talked to him an hour ago, and he swore they weren't going anywhere.
Sir, don't worry. I think we got our lead.
Go on. What is it?
It's a knot, sir. Someone's drawn a circle around the words gas and charter.
Gas and charter. What do I care about gas and charter? Just find out who has my book! Owen Bussy. Kill them.
Kito, what happened to the power?
Oh man, Buana, we've been owned. Check this note out.
Due to the failure of the customer's part to pay the fee of electrical coverage, Armando Power Corp has hereby terminated the contract with this facility. Power will resume once the sum of $4,000 is submitted to your Armando Power Corp account.
Man, we're screwed now.
Oh, man. How are we ever gonna repair them when our pumps are down?
Yeah, selling gas is going to be a whole lot trickier without gas.
Yeah, you said it, man.
We haven't got a choice, have we?
Nope. Let's take this into our own hands.
I've always wanted to tear one of these open and meddle with its insides. The warning tape makes it look like a huge Christmas gift, too. We'll have our power back and customers coming here in no time. Hey, Buana, give me a hand with this. Oh, intriguing. Open the hatch, man. Or are you afraid?
Ha! I'm afraid of no hatch. I'm guessing these are the thingies that hold the hatch in place. Okay, let's open it up.
Hey, it's a switch! I bet it's connected to all sorts of dangerous things. Let's mess with it, man.
You sure this is a good idea, man?
Nope.
Me neither.
Let's do it.
You read my mind, man. Here goes. What was that sound?
Oops!
That's more like it.
Good job, Mon.
Thanks, Mon. Let's go, Mandy Pumps.
Welcome to Buona's Gas and Chata, ma'am.
Hi, I...
Just a moment while I get the pump going.
No, that's all right. I'm not here for...
Hey, wait a minute, lady. Where's your boat?
That's what I'm trying to tell you. I'm not here for gas. I took a taxi. My name is Lena. I come from the university. I'm looking for a very special old book.
A book? Listen, lady. This is a gas station. We don't sell no books.
Actually... For you, lady, we just started selling them.
What you talking about, Buona? We ain't got no books.
Sure we do. Remember Count Andoro's old loft? It's full of old books. They don't do us any good up there.
You got a point, Mon. Anything to clear that debt.
Great. Where can I find them?
Right this way, lady. Oh, man. I knew I had forgotten something.
What? What's wrong?
We used the ladder steps as firewood the other day. For some reason, at the time, it felt like a smart thing to do. Now, I wonder. Looks like we're gonna have to find some new steps for the ladder. You stay put while I figure something out.
Okay, I'll wait right here, Mr. Buona.
I can look at pictures later. We gotta fix the ladder now. Man, the service in this place is terrible. Kito is busy though. I don't blame him for not answering. It's my favorite mug. It's got a dried out slice of lemon stuck at the bottom of it. Nice. But it's not something I feel like carrying around for no good reason. All that's in here is a bunch of boring letters from the power company. I quote, "Dear customer, your power provider, Johnson Electric, has been purchased by Armando Electric, who hereby takes over your current power plan and contract. Contrary to your previous power supplier, we demand payment to be made regularly and on time." Those cold-hearted bastards! Johnson Electric always cut us slack when times were rough. Power to your facility will be cut within a month unless your balance with us is zeroed. I was kind of hoping they were just bluffing, so I sort of forgot about all these letters. Oops. No need for calling anyone right now. Oh, I'd love a nap, but I'm not quite sure Lena would approve right now. Cheese! How I love cheese! I better grab this last piece before Kito finds it. Nice fan! Sorta resembles a propeller, doesn't it? That's my pilot certificate. Count Andoro gave it to me a couple days before he disappeared. I can look at pictures later. We gotta fix the ladder now. Hey! I found breadsticks. I love breadsticks. Holy mother of monkeys. These breadsticks are stale. It's a bunch of folders we made to lively up our business. Never mind the suspiciously low price. Count Andoro's gas and charter covers all of your fuel and transport needs. No questions asked. Call 99450 and we'll make an offer you might not refuse. This might be dumb enough to work.
man, they fit perfectly.
Let's hope they don't snap when we climb them. After you, lady. Man, I haven't been here since I was a little kid. It's just the way I remember it. The only thing missing is that fool of a father of mine, Kaunan Dodo.
Missing? Where'd he go?
We've no idea. He just disappeared one day when we were kids, and we ain't heard from him ever since. But we've done just fine without him here. Aside from some slight financial instability, we've done fine. You find what you're looking for, lady? I wanna get out of here. This place gives me the creeps.
Oh, sorry. No, I can't seem to find the book I'm looking for. Could you help me find it, perhaps? It's supposed to be leather-bound and have a big swirly symbol on its front.
Sure, no problem. I bet it's in this mess somewhere. I think Lena has that shelf covered. It's a picture of me and Kaunan Dodo back when he was around. I remember it as if it was yesterday. Old Kaunan Dodo didn't care how scared I was. I was going to learn how to fly that plane, no matter what. So that's where we hit our paintbrush. It's a bunch of books on plants, trees, and herbs. No swirly sign books here. Sorry. It's full to the brim with moth-eaten clothes. Yuck! Hey, here's a shirt that stayed more or less intact. Looks like it fits me too. I'll keep it. There's nothing left of interest there, man. No, it's not in this pile. Only old children's books there. Nice candles. We used to have them lit all the time back in the day, when Kaunan Dodo was around. Pale as a bone it is. I remember lying in this bed having stories read to us. We had some good times before he dumped us here on our own, that's for sure. I don't remember the bed being so darn stiff though. Wait a minute. There's something. Hey, lady! I think I might have found your book.
You found it! Amazing!
What's so special about this whole thing?
It's the journal of the journey down.
The what?
It's a collection of scribbles and notes on how to reach the Underland.
The Underland? Isn't that sort of illegal?
Yes, so much as touching the Underland literature is illegal. I spend all my time looking for it.
So why did Kaunan Dodo have this? I don't get it.
I've no idea how he fits into this. All I know for sure is who is after me. You know of the Armando Company, I take it.
Sure, everybody knows of them. We recently became customers.
You together with the rest of St. Armando. I have reason to believe there's something fishy going on in the city. And someone is covering it all up. And somehow, I'm certain this book is the key to understanding the whole puzzle. I need to call the university immediately to confirm this find.
Here you go, lady.
I'm sorry, it doesn't seem to be working.
Oh, man! I bet the switchboard reset itself when we lost the power. Give me a second. I'll have it fixed. Yeah, looks like we're gonna need to re-enter the phone number of this place. It would have been a piece of cake if it weren't for the fact that I forgot it. We'll be right back. It's a bunch of folders we made to lively up our business. Never mind the suspiciously low price. Count on Dodo's gas and charter covers all of your fuel and transport needs. No questions asked. Call 99450 and we'll make an offer you might not refuse. Hey, that's the number right there. 99450. I knew painting these folders would pay off.
Professor, this is Lena. Calm down, calm down. What's happened? Good God, did they steal anything? No, that's all right now that we have the book. Don't worry, I know just the place to hide. This plane of yours, does it fly?
That pile of rust down there hasn't been flown for 20 years!
Then you better get her in order fast, Buona. I'm a customer, remember? You know, the kind of person who has way too much money for their own good. Get my drift?
When you put it that way, Buona Air is at your service. Let's go run this by my mechanic, okay? Here she is. A precious airplane. Come on in and check out the insides. What do you think, lady? A beauty, isn't she?
Yes, yes. It's very charming. But can you get her airborne?
Airborne? Are you crazy, lady? This plane hasn't flown for decades.
One moment, please. You got to help me out here. We need this money so bad, and you know it. One flight and our debt to the power company will be long gone. You think you can get her running?
I have no idea. Do you still think you can fly her?
Hey, there's only one way to find out, right?
I guess you're right, Buona. Let's give it a shot.
That's the spirit. Of course we can get her airborne.
Great. That's what I wanted to hear.
Just give us a couple minutes to do some tiny touch-ups and then we'll be on our way.
A couple of minutes? Tiny touch-ups?
Yeah, what's the big deal, man? What are we missing?
Well, for starters, we have no engines.
Oh.
And we're missing a propeller, too. Also, we're gonna need something to steer with.
No worries, man. You get started while I go find the missing junk, okay?
Okay, mon. Good luck, part hunting.
A pair of engines, a propeller, and something to steer with. Shouldn't be too hard to come by. That's my farm of cacti. Cacti rule. These two chairs used to be very comfy once upon a time, until the rodents ate all the juicy padding. Looks like some slightly vital pieces missing here.
That would be the yoke. What sort of pilot are you anyways?
Yes, I knew that. Just checking. I better not poke at these buttons. I don't even remember what half of them do. We don't need to raise anchor now. No wonder Keto smells like fish when he sleeps in this slimy thing. I'll borrow it, just in case I need to catch something. That's Keto with his beloved toolbox. Count and Dodo gave it to him back when we were kids. They've been inseparable ever since. I found this old bike once in the bay, and Keto hotted it up like crazy. That's me and Keto on our Rasta bike. The front wheel couldn't touch the ground, so we had to get off and push it to change direction. What a lovely bike that was. Those are Quito's blueprints. They're all nonsense to me. Those are Quito's blueprints. They're all nonsense to me. I know he'd love the cheese, but what a waste to just simply give it to him. I got no chance catching him. He's way too fast for me. Pointless, yet satisfying. Fun. If only I could get it down somehow so I could use it as a propeller. I can't reach it with that. We got power now. Let's not pick at it. Hola, Makina.
What's up, Buona? What brings you to my fine kitchen?
Food, please.
In your sweet Buani's dreams, Buona.
How's the stew tonight?
Too expensive for you, that's how it is.
Oh, that burns, lady. I'm here for the sweet company.
Sure, Buona. If you say so.
Talk to you later, Makina.
You take care of yourself, Buona.
I don't want to pick at it. Mama Makina's Diner, a shining beacon of hope for any hungry sailor.
A shining beacon of bacon, I'd say.
Really, man? That's a very nice compliment. Hey, Matoki, how you doing, man?
Hi there, Buona. I got all I ever wish from life here. Good cooking and a proper fishing spot. What a beautiful evening. Not a rat in sight.
Rat?
Oh yes, I'm terrified of rats, lad. That's why I be resting me limbs here, you know. They just can't get to me no matter how much they skip about.
That's mighty clever, man. Say, that's a nice fishing pole you got there.
Yep, trusty as heck. Caught me a 12-pound mud juggler the other day.
Wow!
Wow, indeed. I'm quite proud.
A mud juggler?
Come on, Buona. You know it's basically the only thing we catch here in Kingsport Bay. Of course, there's tires and the odd rubber boot. But there ain't much eating on those.
I wouldn't mind missing out on it anyhow.
Oh, don't get too picky. Makena once served my boots to a whole crew of sailors, and they left port happy and dancing. A good chef and a fine spice can fix the foulest stew right up.
Tell me more about mud jugglers.
Sure. They're tricky buggers to pull up, but a fine treat for the tongue if tended to right. Mama Makena turns the foulest jugglers into gourmet magic.
That's a crazy story, but enough about it already.
Hey, you're the one who asked.
Why you never hang around our docks no more?
I'm telling you, man, the rats. I can't stand those foul creatures. They scare me right out of my pants.
That's too bad, man. I liked having you around.
Heck, this ain't far off. Besides, I've been around for a long time. Even the fish knew this was a bad spot.
Yeah, you an old timer, man. How long have you been around Kingsport Bay?
Oh, long before you were born. Roughly 60 or 70 years, I think. Set me up quite the reputation here in Kingsport Bay, too.
You have indeed. So you must know a lot about Kingsport Bay, then.
Oh, don't get me started. I could go on forever about this place. But okay. Kingsport is one of seven bays that surrounds our gorgeous capital, St. Armando. Kingsport consists mainly of industrial cargo docks and random odd enterprises such as your charter and McKenna's Diner. I like it here since the area is so nice and calm, yet it has a great view of the city.
So you must know my father well then.
Oh yes, he was a fine friend till he disappeared. He loved me fish.
Everybody loves your fish, Matoki. Tastiest muddy-ugglers in the bay.
Sure are. Anyhow, I remember him well. And I do think of the captain now and then. Especially remember the flying lessons he gave you. Boy, you were proud.
Of course I was proud, man. He taught me how to pilot this plane at the age of 12.
And you haven't flown the plane since, you fool.
No, not since he dumped us here. I'm afraid of heights, you know.
Learn to fly at the age of 12 and afraid of heights? Don't pull me down.
Talk to you later, Matoki. I gotta run.
See you around, Buona. I ain't going anywhere.
Hey, Matoki. Can I grab one of your mud jugglers?
Oh, sorry, Buona. I'd love to share, but me and McKenna have this deal, you know. If she catches me handing out her jugglers for free, there's going to be hell to pay. You're gonna have to get your own.
Hey, puppy. Yikes! That silly old dog's always blocking that door. Oh, there, you salty sea dog.
Key, kid. You can relax with the salty sea lingo on us. We are sophisticated sailors, we...
Sophisticated! That's what I always said!
Never mind him. He's had a few too many. So what's on your mind, kid? You didn't bother a hungry sailor in the middle of his meal without a real good reason, did you?
Of course not, man. I just had a couple of questions.
Shoot!
What ship are you on?
We're on the fine vessel, MS Corollo. Oh, she's in port over the night for repairs. Caught some bad wind on the last run. But she'll be fine again by tomorrow, and then we set sail again.
Sails?
Figure of speech, lad. We can set engine if you prefer it.
How's the stew tonight?
Oh, it's off the charts, kid. Ain't nothing like a fine stew to warm a sailor's cold bones after a long trip. Woo! It's crazy spicy, though. These chilies are killing me!
Chilies? You don't like them? I love chilies.
Hey, you can have them, kid. Woo! Go ahead.
Thanks, man.
Be careful with those. They can knock an elephant out stone cold.
What are you bound for?
We'll be heading for Port Archu first thing in the morning. Tis a long, eerie voyage along the eastbound edge to get there, so the whole crew's mighty spooked about it.
It's not so good about it.
What's so eerie about the edge, man?
It's scary, man. You've no idea of the spooky things that we've seen deep down in the mist.
Tell me what you've seen down there.
The no way, man. I don't want to talk about it.
I think you better give my companion here a break. He's been shaking crazy since our last trip. Poor man deserves some R&R without having to be reminded of all the scary things hiding in the depths of the mist.
Come on, you're just spooked by old children's tales.
I can tell you this much, kid. They're not all just imaginary tales.
Let's not talk about it. I have nightmares.
I thought going near the edge was illegal.
Oh, commercial vessels with the right contacts and permits can coast along it. But if the powers that be catch anyone so much as glancing over the edge, it's hell to pay.
Yeah, whatever's down there, you don't want to mess with it.
He may be a bit on the fluff-a-rooney, but those words are wise. Stay clear of the edge if you value your life, kid.
Never mind, Mon. Not gonna disturb your soup.
No worries, kid.
It's graffiti. Somebody's written, "People, open your eyes." That's the elevator to the railway station. It won't open without an Armando railway card. It's a card terminal for the elevator to the tram stop. Without an ARA or a maintenance card, I'm not going anywhere. Hey, I found free stuff. It's shaped just like a hook. That there's the MS Corollo. She's a cargo vessel.
Say, are you the new deckhand? You ought to know to report in with me before boarding.
Sure, I'm so deckhand I got two of them.
Good. Let's hear the password.
Password? Chunky chimps.
Nice try, lad. Come back when you remember, and I'll let you aboard. Sorry, lad. Nobody's going aboard except the crew.